This video is sponsored by NVIDIA. Hey folks, Jordy here for CineCam.net. And over the past months, we've been working super hard on a beginner's course for Adobe After Effects. And with much excitement, I can finally say that it has been published to Skillshare. You can find a link to our brand new course in the description below. And if you are new to Skillshare, you can get 2 months for free if you follow that unique link down below. So that's why I thought, let's do an After Effects tutorial today. And I want to cover 17 essential shortcuts that everyone should know. Shortcuts not only makes you work faster, but there are also a few functionalities inside After Effects that cannot be accessed without a shortkey. Starting off with the first one, to call up a property from a layer, you can simply press the first letter of each one to bring it up. P for the position, R for the rotation, etc. However, the O for opacity doesn't work. To bring that property up, you want to press the shortkey T. Next, if you like to call up multiple properties, simply hold down the Shift plus the shortkey for the property that you'd like. We can now start to make some animations and add a few keyframes. Important is that you always create smooth animations. The first keyframe should therefore get an ease out, but instead of jumping into the menu, simply hit Ctrl+Shift+F9. The last keyframe gets an ease in, so here only press Shift+F9. Which brings me to the next one. You might have created a bit too much bezier keyframes and like to reset them back to linear. Well, simply hold down your Ctrl key and click on the keyframe to do so. We've been animating a bunch of properties and would like to make an adjustment to it. Select your layer and press the U key to call up all the properties that have an animation. When you then select all the keyframes or a specific group and hold down the Alt key, you can drag them apart to make your animation go slower or faster. The space between the keyframes will always retain its proportions now. Now I've got 10 more essential shortkeys for you, but first I'd like to show you this brand new NVIDIA GeForce RTX 2080. Now Adobe and NVIDIA have been working together for a long time now to make their programs like Premiere Pro and After Effects work better with the graphical cards. Because the graphical processors are a lot faster than CPUs when it comes down to visual work. And this means playback, rendering, and even a bunch of accelerated effects that grow with every new update. For instance, Lumetri is one of those, which allows me to do color grading tasks instantly and play back the clips in real time. I actually took it to the test and shot some 8K footage with the Red Helium, which I was able to color grade and play back in real time on the RTX 2080. Now, if you're already familiar with NVIDIA, you know that they always had a GTX series. Well, the new 20 series are now called RTX, as they work on a new technology. And at this point, the 2080 doesn't really have a significant performance increase to their previous 1080, but once Adobe updates their ads, we are going to enjoy its full potential. So the RTX series is actually a great future-proof investment. To find out all the nifty details about this card, check the first link in the description below. And now let's continue with the shortkeys. Moving one frame forward or backward is not by pressing the arrow keys like in Premiere Pro, but rather by holding down the Ctrl key and then pressing the arrow keys left to right. An alternative is to use the page up and down buttons for that. Then if you'd like to add a cut or split your layer, press Ctrl+Shift+D. We can now move it around in the timeline, but what if we would like it to start right here at the playhead? Well, then just simply hold down your Shift key to make it snap. This also works when trimming clips to the playhead. Hold down Shift to make it snap. And now that we've become faster in the timeline, let's check out the composition canvas. When designing something in here, you might want to call up the rulers. Simply press Ctrl+R to do so. You can now drag guides out of these rulers into your canvas. With these guides, we can align the different elements better. If you then hold down Shift, those elements will snap to the guidelines. Press G to bring up the pen tool to draw a mask. It's a much used tool, so it will definitely come in handy. After you're done, press the V key to take back the normal selection tool. The anchor point defines the middle of your shape or clip. If you want it to lay in the middle of your element, then use the anchor tool by pressing the Y key. And this allows you to move that anchor point around, and by holding down the Ctrl key, it will snap in the middle of your element. And while you're fine-tuning that mask, you're probably zoomed in at your canvas, which you can do by scrolling your mouse. Now to move around, press the H key to take out the hand tool and drag the zoomed area around. And that brings me to the final essential shortkey. If you'd like to change the name of a layer, simply press the return key to do so. It also works the same in your project window. And those are my 17 essential shortkeys that I believe any After Effects user should know about. Thank you all so much for watching. Thank you NVIDIA for the support today. And like always, stay creative.
So as you guys know, our Red camera was broken, so we had to send it back to the USA to Red to fix it. And Red sent us a loaner camera in the meanwhile. So I'm very excited to see what's inside. Ta-da! It looks exactly the same as ours.